When people think of the documentary genre, they think of stranger-than-fiction real-life stories brought to screen with interviews of real people involved in these stories. Meanwhile, works of fiction, like fantasy and children's comedies, are generally reserved for animated movies. But what happens when you combine the documentary genre with the animation genre? You get a subgenre many don't consider watching or don't even know exists: animated documentaries. The animation can come in many different styles. There is traditional 2D, 3D, stop motion, rotoscope, and experimental. Many may consider animating real-life source material like interviews and dramatizations as inauthentic or even disrespectful to the subject matter or social actors. But what documentarians have begun to realize is that the medium allows for imaginative and effective ways to convey real-life events. Filmmakers like Michelle Gondry, Ari Folman, Keith Maitland, and Penny Lane have looked to animation to tell their stories because it offers them freedom to stylize and reimagine their stories. Being able to capture different perspectives and create a digestible portrait of the events. It also implements an experimental component that reevaluates the common conventions seen in documentaries, allowing for an exploration of alternatives. Is a dramatization too stale or even impossible to shoot? Animate it. Does an interviewee not want to be on camera? Animate them. The possibilities are endless when working with animation. But animation doesn't just earn documentarian style points. They can serve a much greater purpose, like innovative storytelling. For example, a lot of the time in live-action documentaries, when someone is narrating, we either stay on them or B-roll of the crew following them around is shown. What animation does for documentaries is it reproduces the story's reality. Now when someone is narrating, the events can be shown in animation to legitimize the narration with action. These stories are visualized, and they are to be remembered. It is no longer a story being told, but a recounting of history. Thematically, this enhances films like Walsh of Bashir, where memories of war are at times vague, detailed, and teeter between true and false. Filmmakers will often implement real-life footage to contrast the animation. This can create moments of shock for the audience. The animation conditions them into associating the events with the animation. Them seeing the real-life images reminds them that these events actually occurred. The subgenre has garnered attention thanks to critically acclaimed films such as Tower and Flea. Hopefully, because of the success of these films and others, more documentarians will see the benefits of utilizing animation in their documentaries as an alternative to telling their groundbreaking true stories.